Welcome everyone, thank you all so much for always coming to watch my videos. You are most welcome and you're all amazing. And if you have seen my face for the first time, do not forget to hit the red subscribe button after watching this video. Be part of this family and thank you so much. So guys, without further ado, let's get started. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to get a mini job well paid in wherever you are, in Europe or abroad, however you, wherever you are, or even in Africa, or yeah. So that is what we'll be looking into today in this video. I hope you like it. If you do, like, share and subscribe. Some people always think, oh, getting a job abroad or getting a job wherever you are, it is very hard. Yes, you might have that feeling. Of course, you are not getting what you're expecting. You should put that into consideration or be thinking, what am I doing right or wrong that is making me not to get the job that I'm really looking for? Yeah, so those things are supposed to come into your thoughts. Yes, looking for a job for you might be hard because you are not doing the right thing. And you might be thinking, I have searched, I have done the right thing, but yeah, no matter how effort you have put on, the job is not coming forth. And maybe your friends are getting and you are not getting. So what are those things that, you know, the things that should be coming out from your mind, or you should be thinking or putting into consideration, is that after searching and looking for, I have done the right thing, which you have done, what is that thing? Why are people not carrying or not calling me after submitting or visiting so many offices because of my job? I mean, due to my interview or because of my work or job searching. Now, for Africa, for people like us, you know, we say, oh, we are not fortunate. Oh, my parents are after me. Oh, my friends are after me. Oh, people, families are after me. Oh, my village people. I know that's what normally comes to our mind. Remember, the white people, let me use that word, they still suffer a job. They still hunt for a job. They still study hard and still looking for, searching and doing high CV, but they don't still get the job. Okay, but remember again, but they don't think if the village people are after them or not. But now let's stop thinking about that. Do the right thing. Okay, stay focused and do not lose your determination. Be determined, okay, and stay positive. That is what you should have, a positive mind. Okay, now with that being said, let's go into the main video. Forget about your village people are after you or whatever. This is another new year. Have this thought in mind that now I have been searching for a job and I'm not getting any. Okay, now what are those things that I'm doing wrong that you think is right, that after submitting a CV they don't call you? What are those things that you should, that those are those things I should consider? So let's look at this number one point, the CV. Okay, when searching for a job, okay, people think CV is the primary. No, for me, CV is the secondary. Yes, of course, CV are important. CV are place you write your experience general in life and your credentials, your certificate you've gotten, or your, you know, you've acquired. Okay, so that is what you should, like a simple letter, right? Okay, you put it down for them to see your data, okay, both basic and all, to know if you are fit for the vacancy. Now know this, CV is not the primary thing you should consider when searching for a job. What you should think first, okay, before CV, is the language. Okay, now you have a CV, but you can't speak the language they speak in the land or in that country you are or where you are. Nowadays, language is very, very important. It is so important because that is how you can, if you get a job eventually, how are you going to, interact with your fellow colleagues or your boss? How are you going to talk to them? Okay, this is the first thing you should consider when searching for a job. The language is the primary instead of the CV. So the first comes the language and the second one is the CV. Okay, now wherever you are, the language is very important. Some people really don't put interest in a language, but rather they just want a job. Gone are those days where they don't look at the language. Then there were job opportunities, but still there's still job opportunities. Yeah, but now they put it like it is a must and it's good for you also to learn the language. There are so many people living here in Spain, because I live in Spain, let me use that as an example. They can't even speak. If they tell you the amount of years they've been spending here in Spain, some 20 years, some 22, some 30, but they can't even construct a simple Spanish language. Like, it's not good. We are always after money. Yeah, we need to eat. We have families at home, but we should do the things that are right so we could have that money. Now, we don't need to work. There is no job like you can't interact, that you can't speak. I remember then, let me use my mom as an example, was one of the, like, not the, it was second to the boss, okay? But she hardly speak. Even till now, she can't really, she can speak, but she can't construct a good Spanish language. Spanish, just to talk to people. Yeah, but she was a boss. But right now, the category she was then at work, this time, hey, it doesn't exist. So if you don't speak any language well, how do you return? How can you? And if you are opportunity to have that job, how are you going to cope? How are you going to speak? How are you going to interact with your colleague or your client? Yeah. So we should look into that firstly. The second comes your CV. Your CV is your curriculum vitae. So some people really don't know the meaning of CV. Okay, CV, it simply means your curriculum vitae, or yeah, where you write your personal details, your blah 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 blah. Now the second, if you are writing your CV, how do you write your CV, which is the secondary part of you hunting or searching for a job? Now your CV is really important. It is really good for you to analyze your CV very well. If you don't know how to do your CV, you don't need to go to a specialist or go to some people. So there are people who knows how to do it. You can meet your social assistant, you can meet your, there are people, okay, in charge of that can teach you and really help you to arrange your CV properly in a way that it will attract the person that will read or that will interview you or that main job. Of course, if everything, if you have the primary and the secondary, hey, you are good to go. Okay, then number three is good relationship. Eventually, or you have that job, okay, how do you retain? And matters a lot. Yeah, you might get a job of your own choice, well paid as you planned, okay, lucky for you, but it doesn't stay long for you. You need to consider this as well. Good relationship in your working environment matters a lot. Yeah, you don't talk the way you talk at home to your boss, hey, because right now he's the one in charge, he's the one paying you, he's the one feeding you. You don't know that. If you don't know that, know now. Your good relationship on your environmental, your working environment matters a lot. From your boss to your co-workers, they matter. The way you speak, mind the language you use. You don't use F word, okay? for your boss, neither your co-colleague, because you guys are working together in one group, you know, just to reach the objective of, you know, your job. Okay, so that is it. You have to have a good relationship in order for you to retain that job for a long time. Yeah, okay. Do you know what it is to work for years in one same place anywhere? Like, for me, I am so thankful to God. And when I came newly, I went for a language. I make sure I study this language so far. And I interact with the Spanish people. Like, I spent my days, 7 days in a week, 6 days with Spanish people, just for me to learn the language so I can interact and I can use it in my place of work. So I work hard so I could speak that language. Now the language has eaten everything in my mouth. Like, I can't speak English now without adding Spanish, but right now I am controlling it. Thank God for YouTube as well, that is making me to like focus and speak straight. Yeah, so I don't know how some people manage to speak thousands of languages and they don't get confused. Yeah, but we are different anyways. See, if you have 10-6 languages, if you can speak them, the sky is your starting point, not the limits. Yeah, so we need that. Okay, effort and good relationship also matters a lot. Do you know now that we are still going to that first, which is the language, the primary? It is what it is. That one is number one, but we are number three. So let me stop there. So 4 things you need to know again is your way of dressing. That also matters a lot. Now we have from different background, different culture. Yeah, some people are Muslim, some are Christian, we have different ways we dress, right? Now, you can't be given a post of a secretary because you are a Muslim and you dress covering your head and you say you want to attend as a secretary or attend a client in an office with your hair up, or with your cultural wear like this as a Nigerian to your office. But yeah, you can wear that occasionally when they ask you guys to dress in a way. There are days like that, but those are the things you should consider to secure your job after searching for a long time of job. And you should put this in practice, that your dressing, your mode of dressing matters a lot. Yeah, it matters. And as an office person, you are, if you work in an office, there are ways you should dress. Corporate, I recommend suits. Hey, even if you don't have money, if you can buy a suit of, thank God for sales, if you can buy a suit or purchase a suit of maybe 25 or 19 euro, the pants, the under, and the top maybe 29 euro. If you have 2 of it or different colors, you can have 2. Wearing that and ironing all the time, hey, people will like, with a good shoe. If you have 60 euro on the this time says we are, you can get a complete suit, both shoe, even back with it, in less than 100 euro. You can purchase them. Get 3 or 4. Don't buy it, you know, once. But yeah, if you have the money, you can buy it once. But if you don't have, you can buy it, you know, small. So wear those ones to office, and neatness matters a lot. Iron them. Go straight to your office as an office person you are, as a secretary person you are. Hey, let your dressing match with your pose or position you are in your job. Remember, you have been searching and you have gotten this job of your choice. you need to secure it with anything you have, with everything you have, rather. Okay, so those are the things, and I don't want this video to be too long, and I hope this is informative. Please share, like, subscribe. Okay, don't forget, your perfume, the way you smell matters as well. The way you smell matters as well. Okay, normal neatness, normal yourself. Okay, be yourself, do not exaggerate a lot, be normal. Okay, so that is it, and I don't want this video to be too long. Please share, like, subscribe, put this in practice. You will see that this year you won't be hunting for job and not getting any. You must work, and work at the right place you desire to work, because right now you know what you should put in consideration. And yeah, so that is it for this video. Like, share this video. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Until I come your way in my next video, bye bye.